Hi, everyone. I look for a lot of the different secrets and mysteries from all around the world, looking for the coming of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, Emmanuel, the Son of God, who was risen from the dead and took all the sins of the world away. Now the world elite, the Illuminati, the Freemasons, and even the spiritual realms that are all around us, they leave their signs and secrets right in front of us in symbolism. And on our channel, we bring all this back to the Word of God, and we show how we're nearing the end of days. Well, for many years now, I've been showing that these Google Doodles have a lot of symbolism, especially when they're released and such. All around the world, you can see the signs that we're nearing the Bible's end times. The symbolism is all around us. God created all of the universe, and the earth, and the heavens, that everything's going according to a plan. Well, we're nearing this time. This Google Doodle is the 37th anniversary of the Neverending Story. The Neverending Story, which was actually written by Michael Ende, another sign of the end times. Do you see Michael End? For those that don't know the very basics of the Bible, when Michael stands up, it's the end of days. You need to know Jesus Christ as the Lord and Savior, but this is the very basics of the end times. This guy, Michael, the archangel. Jesus Christ comes with the voice of an archangel. And at that time shall Michael stand up, the great prince who standeth for the children of thy people. And there shall be a time of trouble, such as never was, since there was a nation, even to that same time. And at that time thy people shall be delivered, every one that shall be found written in the book. Do you see the symbolism? And many of them asleep in the dust of the earth shall awake, some to everlasting life, and some to shame and everlasting contempt. And then you will be made as a star, and they that be wise shall shine as the brightness of the firmament, and they that turn many to righteousness as the stars forever and ever. There is an end to the story when Michael stands up. Do you see the symbolism that we have right here? Michael End. This is the end story. Well, it is a never-ending story, just as in the Bible. God will remake the earth and remake the heavens. That is what he says he will do. This story goes an awful lot just like the Bible. There are many mysteries that people don't know in the Bible. This whole story called the never-ending story is about saving the princess for the next age and to get the last grain of sand, which was promised to Abraham. Yes. Now what's coming is called the darkness, the nothing. And he's coming after the princess and the children. It's in the Bible. It is the dragon, Revelation 12. Michael and his angels will fight the dragon. The princess that has to be saved is this woman on the moon, right here. Just as yesterday was Princess Diana's anniversary for her death, when the British royal family killed Princess Diana, that represented the dragon coming after this woman that stands on the moon. She is going to be saved by this boy, right here. He saves it all, and it's in the Bible. There's a princess to save. There's a dragon to take down. There's an inheritance to be had by every single Christian. Every single Christian will receive an inheritance because you are a son and daughter of God. This is the woman, and here is her eagle. To the woman were given two wings of a great eagle that she might fly into the wilderness and to her place where she is nourished for a time and times and half a time from the face of the serpent. And this is the worldwide earthquake. And the earth helped the woman, and the earth opened up her mouth and swallowed up the flood which the dragon cast out of his mouth. The nothing is considered to be the darkness. Who is the nothing on the earth right now? The darkness? It is Obama. Obama is the evil seat for Satan and the darkness. Everywhere he goes, there is war and strife, and he is the prince of liars. He is also in love with money and mammon. Obama has spent $10 trillion in 8 years, more than all other presidents combined. It is not a Republican and Democrat thing. Right here in this show here called I Pet Goat 2, showing the goat and the end times and the concentration camps coming, it shows the Republicans are doing a lot of the 911 events and are the sharks, and that also it is the Democrats. Do you see now it is Obama and Bush, and he is Satan fallen as lightning and the dragon. The woman in this show is in this video. She is right there. There is the princess, and all of the Christians in blue go through this door right here. And then Obama will betray the world and start the nothing. Let's go to here. You can see Obama's silver tip boots right here. And then he goes after the children in the school. This is the nothing. This is the darkness. And he goes after the children in the school exactly like the last 911 event. Psalm 23 and the lightning represents the wedding of the Lamb when we are anointed and we go to our wedding feast. But this symbolism is all around us. Here's the girl. Here is the nothing. The darkness. See how he's changing from him? See, they're the same. Bush spent $4 trillion. This guy spent $10 trillion. He is in love with money. That's what it says in the Bible, that he is corrupted. He can't help himself. He is darkness. He is the nothing. The light will beat the dark. You can see him right there. That is in this movie. Now, let's prove this. Let's show how these things just work out. The Neverending Story was release date on July 20th, 1984. Remember, the very basics of this movie is to survive the nothing, which means the end times of the Bible, and then to have the new world born again. And we are past the darkness and the nothing. Apophis, Abaddon, the destroyer. Do you see July 20th? We need to rescue the woman on the moon. See her right here? Well, what happened on July 20th? July 20th, 1969, one giant leap for mankind. Some people say the moon landing was faked. It doesn't matter. It symbolized the woman, the Princess Diana, on the moon being saved from the dragon, which is the British royal family rising up, as we've seen. You can see that there, July 20th, 1969. The woman was rescued off the moon. July 20th, 1984. The woman was rescued off the moon. The end is coming. Do you see this? Watch this. Here is a picture of it. Here is the princess. Here is the sand for the new age. This is the nothing coming. Do you see over here in the right hand? Now here comes the dragon with Russia and Germany and China. Hillary Clinton is ready to release her plagues. Obama, the beast that she rides, is ready to, has taken all the money to most likely dig the underground bunkers and prepare for the great plagues. But we have to pass over the nothing and get all the way over here to the new sand and the new age and the princess back onto the moon. Yes. The Spider-Man character represents the new Holy Ghost protecting her. It's all about protecting her and getting the next age started. This guy wants to kill her and send the whole world into darkness. Yeah. So that's what this whole story is about. Saving the princess and getting away from what's called the darkness, the nothing. What we have called before, and we've shown before, this guy. He is Satan incarnate. the spirit could leave from out of Obama and go to anybody. We don't know exactly how the end times are going to go. This video shows a whole world destruction coming, totally destroyed, and then being remade with the new princess and the new age. So just know that. Mammon, he is in love with money. Between him and Bush, they have spent $19 trillion. And to all of my friends in the black race, he could have given every single one of you a couple million dollars. Instead, he gave it to the white bankers. He does not like the black race either. He has not helped any of you. And he wants the BLM to riot. Watch. Watch. It's already starting. The darkness is spreading. See how it's spreading? Kaepernick to sit out anthem again on military night in San Diego. See, the darkness is coming. Over and over again. This is another man that has left Christ and gone to Islam, and he's sitting out the national anthems. San Diego. Now, to show you a big thing. The darkness is coming after the princess. San Diego has a big thing to do with protecting the princess. This guy right here is playing the symbolism of the red dragon coming after the woman. Because as I keep saying, San Diego has a big thing to do with protecting the woman of the Bible and her getting her wings. This San Onofre power plant is just a giant bomb right on the San Andreas fault line and will cause the great earthquake of Revelation 12 that will help this woman and bury the dragon to receive his grievous wound. I'm not kidding. This is a glyph of Akhenaten, which compared to Obama. Remember, from Abraham to Jesus went to Egypt. Moses was taken out from underneath the burdens of Egypt. This clown is considered the fifth angel coming with the key to open the abyss and to do this nuclear event. And then he will be riding the red horse of war. This is the dog star Sirius, part of God's throne and the star of Bethlehem. The left-hand side is Satan the accuser. Here he comes. The right-hand side is where Jesus Christ sits in the power of God. There is the eagle granted to the woman. Do you see these two domes? They represent the San Onofre power plant. And then the mask will come off of Obama, and he will be as a spirit to go off and try to bring the nothing and the darkness across the world. The bear of Russia will rise. Here's that clown seen as the false prophet. And then over here is the mark of the beast. See the two domes and the eagle? Here comes the dragon, who will not stand for our national anthem. He just converted to Islam, and he is coming to San Diego, the dragon. This is San Diego, and right here is where the San Onofre power plant is, and do you see the eagle mapped out for the woman? Clemente means mercy, clemency, right by the San Onofre nuclear power plant. Here is the eagle for the woman, and here comes part of the dragon, the darkness, the nothing. Confess with your mouth the Lord is Jesus. Believe in your heart God hath risen him from the dead, and you'll be saved. Hallelujah. That is the nothing, Satan, Apophis, the destroyer, the waster. What is inside of his body is Satan, and he wants to kill this woman and bring all of this rage and hate with Russia and Germany and China. He wants the USA destroyed because it represents grace and mercy. And then over here is the new world being born. Thank you very much, everybody. That's what all of this represents. And he's heading to San Diego. We don't know a date, but the woman's eagle is ready. There's going to be a new world, a new heaven. This one is ending. We are at Michael's end. Thank you very much, everybody. I'll see you at the wedding feast of the Lamb. Confess with your mouth the Lord is Jesus. Believe in your heart God hath risen him from the dead, and you'll be saved. Hallelujah. We are going to beat the darkness.
Have you ever been Captain Nemo? Trapped inside your submarine?
Yes.
Aren't you afraid you couldn't escape?
But it's only a story.
That's what I'm talking about.
Bastion wanted to escape from reality.
We each have responsibilities. We can't let Mom's death be an excuse for not getting the old job done, right?
In his loneliness, he found a book.
What's that book about?
Your books are safe. This is something special.
What he didn't know was that he would unlock the secret to the greatest story ever told.
Why is it so dark? In the beginning, it is always dark.
Nothing is destroying our world.
The Plains people have among them a great warrior. He alone has a chance to save us.
But that's impossible!
Easily. I am a warrior.
Brave warrior. Then fight the nothing.
But I can't. I can't get beyond the boundaries of Fantasia. What's so funny about that?
Fantasia has no boundaries.
That's not true. You're lying.
Boy, don't you know anything about Fantasia? It's the world of human fantasy. Every part, every creature of it is a piece of the dreams and hopes of mankind. Therefore, it has no boundary.
But why is Fantasia dying then?
Because people have begun to lose their hopes and forget their dreams. So the nothing grows stronger.
What is the nothing?
It's the emptiness that's left. It is like a despair. Destroying this world. And I have been trying to help it.
But why?
Because people who have no hopes are easy to control. And whoever has the control has the power.